Hey everyone, my name is Root and we are here. This is going to be round one of the ICBA playoffs, and we got beat up pretty badly in our final week. So we got a pretty bad seed and we ended up going up against Kelly Under the Radar, and he's a really good friend. I love the guy to death, but he has a very scary team, and this is a very interesting matchup. So I feel like parts of my team match up okay, but I really kind of forced myself to build really differently against his team than I would normally. Normally I would kind of rely on, you know, fat and momentum, but I know Kelly is gonna be prepared for that quite a bit, and so I kind of brought the house in terms of all of my offensive mons. Usually there's one that I would hold back due to matchup or something like that, but I just brought everything and I'm gonna hope that it works. I'm gonna take a screenshot of this team. Okay, so here we see the Scolipede, Jellicent, Landorus, Lucario, Skuntank, and CLEFABLE. Okay, so right off the bat, Namega Latios. It's pretty interesting, but somewhat expected. So, okay. Randy HLD was actually telling me that I should have more of a strong ice stab for the Mega Latios specifically, but I'm going with just Ice Shard for this match. No Rotom Heat, which is really, really interesting. That's really, really interesting. No Steelix as well. Reasonably interesting. No Porygon. That's huge. No Porygon is huge, but I think the biggest one might honestly be no Rotom Heat. Maybe didn't expect my Mamoswine, but my Mamoswine is really interesting here. I think what I want to do, part of me just wants to lead off with my Thunderous here. Thunderous has an interesting time in this matchup. What are his hazards? He could set up spikes on me. Yeah, he has full like spikes and rockets and Fable and Scolipede. I think I might honestly just want to lead off with my Lele here. I'm going to go for it. I'm going to trust in my pivots a little bit. And actually, my Drudagon, right? My Drudagon is Lumberry EQ Moldbreaker. So that if he Will-O-Wisp me with Rotom Heat, then I can Lumberry that off and then hit it with a Moldbreaker Earthquake. But I guess that's never going to come to pass. But that was my my plan here. Does lead off with this thing. This is interesting. So maybe I should have led off with Thunders. Let me think here. Honestly, is there that much of a downside to just clicking Z Psychic? Would he really make the super aggressive play into Skuntank? I can pretty easily Moonblast here. I don't know what he wants to do. Maybe this thing is super specially defensive. I'm gonna try to see a calc if this thing is specially defensive. Jellicent. Alright, so the default one is physically defensive. But yeah, specially defensive takes hits super duper well. Maybe this thing wants to take a hit and toxic me. I can also pop a taunt, which was a Randy HLD suggestion. I really don't know how much he would want to go into Skuntank right now. I'm going to click taunt. We do get the taunt off. I'm very curious to know what this thing goes for turn one. Okay, it does just scald me. So I'm going to go for it. I'm gonna go for it. Shattered Psyche. Don't switch out. If this thing is like complete max special defense, then I don't take any. Maybe he did expect me to switch out. Maybe he thought that I would go into. I don't know. There's the. Okay. Okay. I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous. But let's see. Let's see. I'm super curious to know how much damage this does, because fully specially defensive should take it, but yeah, okay. Physically defensive makes more sense against things like my Mamoswine and my Infernape, but I think the check to that is going to be gone. If he expected a regular... Yeah, there's a Skuntank, that's fine. I think I'm honestly fine just going into Dredagon here. Goes for the Pursuit. I think that's fine. I'm not too concerned about HP on my Lele. I don't think. Because, yeah, things like Lucario and Scolipede are always going to destroy me. I mean, it's going to limit being able to take a Pursuit later on in the match, but I'm just going to have to manage that as well as I can. I don't know if you would. I'm going to set up rocks. He might. I don't know. Does this thing get toxic smash? I'm actually not too sure if it does. I don't think it does, but I'm just going to set up rocks. See where that gets me. I just want to see where that gets me. Just go for the taunt. Okay, that's fair. That's totally fair. Part of me says I'm okay to EQ here, but knowing that, he might not stay in. I kind of want a Dragon Tail, in honesty. I might want a Dragon Tail, honestly. Oh, I feel really bad. Did I forget to nickname all my Pokemon? No, just a Dragon. Okay. For the record, this Dragon's name is Andres. I can pop a Dragon Tail, right? Clefable would be a super obvious play. Maybe the Landorus expecting me to want to... Yeah, I think he goes... Landorus makes the most sense here. Goes for the Pursuit, okay. So, that did a decent amount of damage, and I get to drag something out, the Clefable, okay. That's pretty unfortunate, but... I would be interested to try to... Gunk Shot on this thing. Where's my Dredagon? Looks like Max Defense Gunk Shot does... right around 50? Cosmic Power, okay. That's... okay. Okay. Okay, I don't want to lose to this thing, but there's the Gunk Shot. Yeah, that's pretty much Max Defense, I'm pretty positive. At plus one. I was gonna say, it's probably Magic Arts, that doesn't matter. What do I do? What do I do? Let me just check on one thing. At plus one defense. Actually, it might not be max defense. Will I just lose to this thing? Would I just lose to this thing? Because I don't want to... I really can't give up too many of my resources. Maybe the Thunderous is the most expendable. I think I can reasonably go into Thunderous here. I think I can reasonably go into Thunderous. Now, let me see. This thing could be Magic Art Life Orb for all I know. Oh no, it's Leftovers. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm just too nervous. I'm genuinely just too nervous right now. Oh, but it's not Calm Mind, so it's not raising its special attack. Which means Moonblast, I mean, assuming no attack investment, should be no special attack investment. I think I can Nasty Plot here. I'm gonna go for it. I think if he gets greedy and goes for some more cosmic powers, then this might be reasonably free, and then I can start to... Okay. Yeah, that looks to be exactly right for no investment whatsoever. But now I can go for some sludge waves. And I can try to wear this thing down now. Sludge wave should be doing over half. As long as we're both neutral on each other. But I don't think he's now going to ever be in a position to really cosmic power up too high anymore. Sludge wave is reasonably obvious. He could go into honestly, sludge wave only barely does more than thunderbolt, so he might want to make the aggressive play into Lucario, but that would be really bad for him if he calls that wrong and I do go for the thunderbolt. Just switch out. Goes into this. I mean, this thing can sucker punch me, but I can. I have to imagine that I take a sucker bolt. Oh, a sucker bolt. A sucker punch. Okay, and I can react back with thunderbolt. I'm genuinely super nervous, but he's gonna see pretty much my entire moveset. That's a +2 thunderbolt. I'm not gonna get hit by aftermath or anything like that. But yeah, I have to play super carefully around that Clefable. Whatever comes in, oof. I think he's realizing my full set, and he might be realizing now that I. Okay. So we are back after quite a bit of recreation. There are a few things that are going to be different, so I didn't even look at that Moonblast roll, but it looks different just to my eye. He got a little bit of extra damage onto my Lele, and he got to keep a little bit of extra HP onto his Clefable, and it never got poisoned, which doesn't matter, but whatever. Basically, we're going to be here, and I have to wonder in my head still whether or not this thing is going to be scarfed, and I also have to wonder. Honestly, I don't know if he would pack Rock Slide. I don't know if he'd pack Stone Edge. I know he's relied on Stone Edge quite a bit in his prior matches, but this would be an interesting event right now. I'd be more curious to know whether or not this thing is scarfed than anything else. My instinct tells me that he wouldn't want to Stone Edge this early on in the match. He would just want to, click U-turn. Oh, and I also got Rocks up against him. Which does kind of stink, but it's going to just have to be what it is. Kelly doesn't want to particularly recreate this match, so we can just run with it. I feel like he clicks U-turn. If he's scarfed, he clicks U-turn, I feel like. He could also just be scarfed and click Stone Edge, and then I'm going to do it. U-turn. Does get the Rock Slide to land. So everything that I thought was wrong does take me out. That's totally fine. But that does confirm Scarf on Landorus. So I would like to make somewhat of an aggressive play on this. I can go into Rotom and Volt Switch. That feels like my play to make. So this Rotom is Thunderbolt, Volt Switch, HP Ice, and Will-O-Wisp. I don't know, and it's also max defense, so if he wants to play these games with Rock Slide, he absolutely can, but yeah, it just goes into the Clefable. And essentially, I have to be sure that the Clefable can be put in range of something interesting. I mean, I can go into. This is probably a reasonably free Lele here, right? Psychic doesn't look like it's doing a ton here, which does suck. I don't know what to do. Does Mammoth want to do more? Maybe just giving up a Lele here would be fine. Is something wrong here? Why is Clefable? Oh, because I still have the plus. I saw the plus twos from the earlier Calm Minds. So So yeah, Laylee is doing okay damage. I think giving up Laylee here for damage is the best play I can make. I think that's probably the best play that I can make right now. But, I mean, I can taunt this thing too. He has to know that I'm taunt, but he wouldn't switch out in this situation. He no longer has his Skuntank, so something's gonna get psychic, and it might as well just be this thing. That is some very decent damage. Moonblast is probably gonna take me out, which is gonna suck, but it's gonna be how this plays. He doesn't have any switch-ins left to a Mamoswine here. He doesn't have any switch-ins left to a Mamoswine here. And getting rid of this thing is just going to make me feel so much better for this endgame. The Lucario can come in, but the fact that the Gardevoir is still up gives me a lot of hope here. Part of me also really wants to click sub. Let me see. I know that this is a no. Yeah, I just had to click Earthquake. It's fine. If Ice Shard did a little bit more damage, I could freely go for Ice Shard in case he wanted to go into the Mammoth, into the Landorus. But the fact that the Rotom is up and Landorus cannot lock itself into Earthquake, for as long as I can maintain that state of affairs, then I think I will be feeling pretty good here. Maybe Infernape would have been a better play. Let's just let this thing go down. I don't know. But Mamoswine is in. His best play would probably be Lucario. That'll let me go into the Drudagon. And he could Swords Dance up on that, in all honesty. Lucario. A Swords Dance Lucario with Meteor Mash. Up against my Drudagon here. Ooh, I don't switch in on Meteor Mash that well. Rotom potentially? I feel like I shouldn't, I really shouldn't risk my Rotom that much. But after Drudagon goes down, even if he does get a Swords Dance up, if Drudagon does go down, then, okay, so here's another thing, right? So, okay, goes into this thing. I don't know how much I care about this thing. I mean, how well does Drudagon deal with this? With a Scolipede. This thing could also be Swords Dance, which would be unfortunate, but it looks like I take two Mega Horns. My Infernape, okay. My Rotom is really built for this, but my Rotom ideally would be able to deal with both this and the Landorus. I think I go into Drudagon here. Let's see whatever happens. So, yeah, I never get to use my Lumberry Drudagon tech, but I should take two of whatever this thing wants to hit. Goes for the Swords Dance. If this thing is Z, then that's unfortunate. Has he used a Z move? I don't think so. But yeah, this thing should be a Z Captain. It's not a Z Captain. Okay. I think I take +2 of anything. I'm at 164, so I'll check out what each what percentage that puts me at. That's 89%. If this thing is at plus 2, I should always take a plus 2 Mega Horn. That's max attack Jolly. Maybe this... Could this thing afford to be Adamant? Maybe not. If this thing is Adamant, then it has a 31% chance to Oko with a Mega Horn. I think I just take those odds and click Dragon Tail. Earthquake does marginally more, but at this point, does it really matter? I'm just gonna click Dragon Tail. I guess we just see what happens. Goes for the Poison Jab. We should always take that. Unfortunately, we don't get any kind of Rust Skin chip or anything like that, but we do take that. And this thing's gonna get phased out. I don't particularly care about this Landorus. Or about this Redigon, I should say. I think I'm reasonably free to just see whatever this thing wants to lock itself into and click Dragon Tail here. Locks into Rock Slide. We take that because... We take that and flinch. Oh, no! I really wanted that damage, man. I really, really wanted that damage. But now... I can actually harden to Rotom. Landorus. Landorus, Landorus, Landorus. Against Rotom. Let me see. I'm gonna have to count these things out. 157 down to 115 is 42. 142 with Rock Slide instead of Stone Edge. Forty-two is a pretty low roll for Jolly. Well, mid to low roll. Okay. So I think I can. I think whether it switches out or not, I can Will-O-Wisp this thing. Okay. I was just curious to know whether or not this thing would want to switch out on me. But... This might... Actually, would this let my Mamoswine set up a sub? Will this let my Mamoswine set up a sub? If this thing is burned... It does let Mamoswine set up a sub. Do I do that? I really want to do that, because that could be a game-winning play. Because Ice Shard should take out the Scolipede, and then behind a sub, I should 1v1 the Lucario. This could be a game-winning play if he lets me get behind a sub. Let's withdraw. Interesting. So I wanted to take the HP Ice, but Ice Shard is going to do the same thing here. Ice Shard is going to do the same thing here. Scolipede. Yeah, Ice Shard always KOs. I don't know, this thing could be max HP too.
I even take an Aqua Tail here. Aqua Tail would actually let me get a sub up as well. Really? It does also protect against the Protect. This thing could be Life Orbed and I don't think it matters. This thing could be Banded and I don't think it matters. No, Choice Band might actually matter. Yeah, Choice Band definitely matters. I'm gonna click sub. I'm gonna do it. Yes! Oh my god! That's wild. Oh my god. That is wild. Because that's gonna allow me to Ice Shard. I think after Rocks it might KO the Landorus. This is potential. This is very, very, very potentially checkmate territory. I'm not too sure. It just messaged me and said GG, dude. I don't know what that means. He does go into this thing. The Intimidate's not going to go through. I'm going to be able to click Ice Shard. It just says, nah, you win. LOL. I do feel really bad because when we were trying to recreate this match, he accidentally clicked Pursuit on my Dredagon on the turn that I went for Stealth Rocks because the idea was he was going to taunt me. I clicked Stealth Rocks, the turn is dead, like it was in the original match. He accidentally let me get Stealth Rocks in this matchup, which I think ended up hurting him, especially with the Scaldipede in particular. But whatever happened here was absolutely bananas. Mammoth Spine's going to pick up the last three KOs. I'm blown away. So, I mean, honestly, I really truly hope that Kelly isn't too upset. I was really hoping for a cleaner setup than this. And I think ultimately we played up a really clean game, except for a few different changes. He got a little extra damage on three of our Pokemon, and I got up rocks, so who knows how that really like plays out in the grand scheme of things, but that's going to be round one of the ICBA playoffs. We took out the number two seed. And honestly, if Dai wins this match, I think that puts us on a collision course with Dai for a rematch, which is going to be pretty, pretty brutal. But that's going to be it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll be back really, really soon with more. We see the ICBA, the Pokemon Grand Prix, and some other projects in the really near future. But with that, once again, thank you guys so much for watching. Once again, out.